full scale mechanical awesome roller. It was presented by Justin Solero, Kyle Denny, Jeremy B., Daniel Turner, and Robert Wagner. The industrial grade boss machine is required to increase boss at 1 meter, at 5 meters per second, and 1 meter wide. The rollers to squish the pasta are constructed with a stainless steel shaft wrapped by PVC. This is to create a lightweight shaft. The dimensions of the roller is outer dimension, I mean diameter of the roller is 0.25 centimeters. Modified Goodman analysis was used to determine the life of the rollers. The life cycles have to be infinite since it was greater than 10 to 6 cycles. JB Weld was used to create bond between PVC and stainless steel shaft. This bond is quite sufficient for the torque that the system will experience.
How's it going, man? For a wire, and I'll be discussing the motor and the gear train. The motor that we chose is a 1 horsepower motor at 1725 RPMs. It's 80% efficient. It is used for fixed speed constant torque applications. It's a three-phase motor, which is more durable than a one-phase and requires less power because it doesn't have to use capacitor switches or replacement startup. The price of the motor is $200. The gear train that we designed has a 4.5-to-1 gear train ratio. The interference requirement for the number of teeth in the pinion was 16, which gave us 73 teeth on the big gear, or the larger gear. The diameter of the gear, or the larger gear, is 0.2 meters. The pinion diameter is 0.043 meters. The phase width that was chosen from the AGMA stress analysis that we did, that I'll discuss later, is 0.5 inches. The performance parameters of the gear train are the torque that was output is 18.65 newtons per meter, which is much larger than is required, but it will allow for the pasta to go through at a constant speed without any worry about different consistencies of the pasta. The angular frequency output by the gear train is 40 radians per second, which gives us a pitch line velocity at the rollers of 5 meters per second. The AGMA stress analysis that we did was based on a 10 to the 9th cycles, which is infinite life. Bending stress in the pinion was 4,550 psi. Bending stress in the gear was 2,900 psi. The contact stress was about 54,000 psi. The factors of safety, the bending stress factors of safety, the pinion was 9.3, the gear was 12.1. For the contact stress factors of safety, the pinion was 3.15 and the gear was 3.25. Thank you.
I'm Justin Solar, and I'm going to be talking about roller bearing selection. This boss machine has two different sources that apply a load, and one is the force of the pasta, which is 100 newtons, and the weight of the roller, which is 775 newtons. The dimensioning of the bearings are the bore of the bearing is 40 millimeters, while the ring diameter is 68 millimeters, with a bearing ball diameter of 8 millimeters. Stresses that act are an axial load transmitted on one or two bearings. Maximum subsurface stresses are 910 megapascals, while minimum subsurface stresses are 505 megapascals. Using a modified Goodman analysis, we found that the ultimate strength was 1,750 megapascals and the endurance strength was 760 megapascals. Alternating stresses was a stress of 707 megapascals and stress amplitude of 202.5 megapascals, which gives us a factor of safety of 1.5. The life cycle analysis gave us a fatigue that gave us a life of the bearing as about 1.14 months, which would mean that the bearing would need to be replaced every month or so, which is easy to do because they are at the end of the steel rods. So in conclusion, we will have rollers that consist of a stainless steel shaft of 4 centimeters, PVC wrap of 25 centimeters, and an infinite life. The gear train will be a 4-gear arrangement with 2 driver pinions and two driven gears with 365 teeth per meter diametrical pitch. And once again, the bearings have a 68 millimeter outer diameter bearing with a 4 centimeter inner bore to mate with the shaft. And they have a 1 month maintenance schedule. And that is our process.